Good morning. Welcome to Avid Adventures Part 7. Now, this is a really exciting one for me. I haven't fished this particular lake for probably 6 years. I've done a lot on here in the past. Sandhurst Lake at Yateley. Day ticket water full of whoppers, okay? So this is where we are. Now, I've got a Yesti, which some of you might think is a bit sneaky, actually, but day ticket fishing, especially one like this, which has got 10 fish over 40 pounds and probably another 30 or 40 over 30 pounds, is going to be busy. So I tipped up Yesti to try and get us two swims next to each other. My guest, should we call him one? Guest, mate, debatable, Spencer Rumble. Our avid big fish expert. Now, all joking aside, good angler. We're on a great lake. He's due here in about 10 or 15 minutes, so nothing's happened yet. I've done the night, absolutely freezing cold, but 19 degrees today. I do know the lake well. What I've done, actually, before we'll quickly say goodbye before he gets here, is I've touched on it's busy. We're at the far end of the lake where it hasn't been fishing very well. That might surprise you, but there's 12 anglers on last night, and 10 of them are at the far end. I could have gone in amongst all them on my own, but there's two swims to be had on these things, okay? So I didn't put myself in the killing zone up there amongst all that cat's cradle of lines. We've come at the far end. We're in a swim known as the Bailiffs, which of you that have fished it will know it's quite a big area. It suits what we're going to do. Two anglers, a cameraman, and loads of space. And we're not affecting anyone else's water. So all we need now is a massive shoulder carp to get bored up there of all them leads and winkle their way down here. So what we'll do is when Spencer gets here, we'll have a little chat with him and see what he thinks. Morning. Right, Spencer, humble, you've had your half hour. What you done?
Well, after you stitched me up with getting here a day early.
I don't know what you mean.
Turned up with one swim to go in.
Yeah, that's
luckily
a lot.
For me and unluckily for you, there is fish showing in that swim. So basically, I've just put three singles out. Just literally whacked them out there and see what happens for the morning.
Yeah, there's been a few showing, haven't there?
Yeah, there has, to be honest. So. Yeah,
I might actually, because there's a massive wind at the moment going this way, isn't there? None whatsoever. So I might have to sort of air slightly to the right when I recast
later.
Don't
think that's going to happen, to be honest with you.
No, I didn't think you would. But there is room to get another couple of rods in here. All joking aside, though, the first one that showed was a big one, wasn't it? So
yeah, the one on the right-hand spot rod did look good, to be honest with you. So that's the one.
And you're known as our massive carp. Yes, he is. Anyway, listen, I've bent your ear enough. Before we go, first time you've been here. Yes, I've rammed you into the last swim on the lake. What do you think of it?
It's a lovely place to be at Yateley, to be honest with you.
Yeah.
I've read all about it for all my life growing up around.
Read all about it.
It's just a lovely place to be.
Yeah, it is, mate.
It's busy, but everybody's up that end, so fingers crossed.
As long as they stay up that end. Well, I think that's why you've seen a couple here this morning, because there are... I said it earlier, I think there's about 12 or 13 anglers altogether on, and there's you and I down this end. Yeah. They're all up there in the kill zone, but you've got a group of fish clearly turned up here, so fingers crossed.
Can't ask anything more than that, really, can we?
Well, I'm going to leave you to get your bivvy up, and as usual, when I'm on these things, as usual, I'm going to go and make the tea all day.
Good, look forward to it. Ta-da. Thank you very much. Rods have been out for a few hours now. We're just coming into early afternoon, and despite the fact that I was stitched up with this duff swim, it seems to be there's a few fish present. We have seen two or three, or four or five really, actually, to be fair. So Ian's a bit gutted that he's sitting in the swim next door. He's hiding in his bivvy at the moment. So we're stuck with the plan. We've just got single hook baits out there since this morning. It's really difficult at the moment to know what time we're going to try and set some traps properly, or whether we're just going to carry on doing the same thing and leave singles out there. At the moment, I think it's more likely to be just going to put a scattering of bait out there and then just fishing for a drop and hoping that the fish are still there. Don't want to disturb them too much, but hopefully we can wangle one. Hopefully this evening, there was a guy over the other side who had one, I think at 9 o'clock last night. So there's bites to be had in the evening as well. But I think we're waiting now really for the light to start to fall so we can start building a plan.
I'll turn up before you, grab the worst swim clearly, and put you in the bunghole. And what's going on now then?
Yeah, we've got one on.
Go on, I'll leave you alone because there's some lumps in here, mate.
Thank you very much.
Sweet. I'll show you emotion.
So here we go. First Yateley fish from Sandhurst. Avid Adventures 7. Just on 20 pound. And the prize for chucking out three singles and sitting on my hands, really. But, first one, hopefully, of one or two. Cracking fish.
Right. First day is coming to an end. The evening's drawing in, so we'll do a little closure while we've still got enough light. Spawny Spence. Did I call him that? Yeah, I did, actually. Who ended up in the worst swim on the lake, which wasn't actually happens, but saw a few fish in front of him, and as he would do, he's managed to nab a 20 pound on the button. I didn't see it weighed, mirror carp. So well done, Spence. Bear in mind, he's only been here the day and he only started fishing mid-morning, but there was a few fish moved into that corner. And as I say, as Spencer would, because he's our big fish specialist, he's managed to snare one. They have now shifted a little bit more across in front of me, maybe a little bit to my left as it happens out here, but that may be that I can catch one or two in the night or early morning. My dinner's on now, rice and chicken. Not surprised, are you? anyway, so unless we catch one or two in the night, which we will bring the camera back on, then we'll see you in the morning. And hopefully the early morning period, which we've been led to believe is the period to have your baits in. So we're all set now. All six rods are out there. Baits are on top of them. Let's see whatever the night brings. Or I'll see you in the morning. Good night. Morning. As you didn't get an update during the dark hours, it's plainly obvious that's because nothing happened. Heard a few in the night, not many, not as many as we'd like to have heard, and had the odd liner, we all did. Well, there were some of the liners were swans actually, because there's quite a few of them on here. But no, serious note, nothing else has happened fish capture wise. I reckon because Spence was so good yesterday afternoon catching that one, he scared them all. They're all scared of Spence today, but nothing happened. I'll tell you what has happened, which is absolutely mega. Spencer started making tea, and that is because Ian ran out of water yesterday because Spencer drunk it all. So we've had one good thing come of it. The day's bright again. It's going to be a real roaster today. So who knows? To be fair to Spence, his bite was yesterday afternoon. We're sort of mid-morning now, but we're not even seeing them now. Never mind. we have got a good few hours left yet anyway, so the update is nothing's happened, probably nothing's going to happen, having a Spencer making another tea. Let's see what the day brings. Right, the swim I'm in, let's talk about this and what I'm doing. The bailiff swim, which is quite a big swim, and it's suited, I did say earlier it's suited what we've got to do, but other than that, a swim with no fish in it is not worth setting up in. So I have seen fish here, and I had seen fish here when I sort of got this area ready for myself and Spencer. The bailiff swim, fished it years ago, but things do change. I started off with the deeper, always use the deeper. It is two or three casts, and bear in mind the deeper only comes across the surface. It's not a lead crashing to the bed of the lake and dragging it through if there are fish there. Brilliant product. Enough of that, pushing the product. Bought it across. I've gone at about 19 wraps with the deeper. When you get to 17 and a half, you're in that dip. Now this swim is quite famous for having a trench. It comes from my left, about 25, 30 yards off the island. It comes through here, gradually getting deeper, and it ends up in front of peg 19 on about 10 foot. I've got 8 to 8.5 foot in the middle of the trench out here. That's where I've applied all three rods, because also on the deeper, we had beep, 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 a good few fish scattered about. So I've done my three casts over the area in line with peg 13, where I'm going to be putting the rods, and that's enough. Deeper off, I'd clipped it, so I know the range, and it's 17 and a half wraps. What I done then was, this was for the day I got here, I put three little bags out with three little yellow pop-ups, because I don't want any more disturbance going on until what the bailiffs have told me at the time is bite time has gone past. So I left that all day. Nothing happened, to be fair. And in the evening, I put out my favourite. Two tins of F1 corn, 17 and a half wraps, and just staggered it along between pegs 14 and 13 on the far margin. And that was it. So it's all gone in the deep water. The rigs I used, and although nothing's happened yet, I'm so confident it will happen. We've got to be confident, otherwise you've got to move, haven't you? Years ago when I fished here, I didn't overcomplicate things, as I never really do with my angling, but we used tiny little plastic coated hook link, size 4, size 6 actually on this one, a size 6 long shank, because I've run out of 4s, plastic coated hook link, and this new tubing we've got at Avid, I've got to say, I keep pushing at the shows, I'm not overdoing it with our product, but this shrink tubing, what that doing is there is sort of emulating the old bent hook rig, but when you hook a fish, it straightens out, so there's, you know, no point, no chance of this getting double hooked and all that like the bent hook rig supposedly did. But that's what I've got there. When I tie these rigs up, they go on the rig board, and that shrink tubing retains its curve in there. So that's what I've got. Tiny little split shot called a stot at the bottom of the tubing, which looks really super cool because, super cool. That's a good one. Super cool because it's the same diameter as the tubing. Not that it makes any difference to the fish, but it makes it nice and neat. Little yellow pop-up over two tins of F1 corn. What more can I say? I'm tired of having all this action. What I will say is this. It hasn't happened yet, I'm sure it will, but what is working against us, and we've got to abide by fishery rules, it is blister or not by lunchtime. We know the fish are up in the water, but we're not allowed to fish zigs. Now I know this little film, for both myself and Spencer won't fish zigs. Apparently when you catch fish on zigs in Spencer's world, over there making a tea, they don't count. That's not so with me. Years ago when we were fishing here, you were allowed zigs, and we absolutely slaughtered it on zigs. They're not allowed anymore for whatever reason the fisheries decided upon, but I know damn well if we were allowed to fish zigs yesterday, and look at it today, they're up and down here, they're round in front of Spence. If we were fishing zigs, we would be catching carp. Stick within the rules. If I don't get any carp on this trip, it's not because we haven't tried within the rules we're allowed to fish. It's because we can use zigs. But there you go. Staying within the rules, try my little yellow pop-ups. It's only 8 foot deep. Of an evening and overnight, I'd expect them to drop. We'll carry on as we were, but at least we didn't bend them. So stick with us, and hopefully later today, I'll be going, I think that looks like Nigel's mirror. Stick with us.
So we're 24 hours in, and the weather's taken a little bit of time for the worse. It is now roasting hot in February. So a little bit unexpected, so a little bit of break from the fishing. Just thought I'd run you through what I'm using so far. As we said earlier, turned up yesterday. Ian had stitched me up and left me with the duff swim. It didn't actually turn out to be the case because there was a few fish there. So rather than messing around, markering up, leading about, etc., generally what I've come is just come in with the rig that I use for pretty much all of my fishing, which is something that can be presented, pretty much over anything. So I haven't got to worry too much about it, which is basically just a little hinge rig, done sort of multi-rig style on one of our helicopter setups, all of our sort of chod components. On our chod components and our pin down leader, which is pretty much chuck it anywhere. As long as you feel for a drop, generally you're going to be fishing. And that's what I did to do with the fish yesterday. So we're just hoping that the fish are still in the region. The weather isn't ideal, but we'll do our best and hopefully this will sort them out.
Day two, Spensor. Is it Spensor or Spencer?
It can be whatever you want it to be, no problem.
It's better.
Yeah, sir is better. Yeah, definitely add sir in, that's fine.
But there you go, we're still on one fish. Spencer's. Actually, I have had a problem there, and because I had one fall off. So we've had, should we say, we're still on two bites, one fish.
Yeah, that's much better.
You're on one fish. But a few more angles at this end now, mate, aren't there?
Yeah, I think word's probably spread that there has been bites at this end of the lake and not anywhere else. So, yeah, as usual on a day ticket lake, you've got a few other people joined us.
Put up with it, buddy, haven't we?
Yeah, definitely.
But today would have been, and I know I said it earlier, perfect zig day, not allowed to use them, so we are risking a one fish film. But at least we're staying within the boundaries, mate. And we've got a night. Look at
we've still
night
got a night.
Good, doesn't it?
My middle rod is going to rip off any minute anyway, so that's fine.
A bit like you do with everyone at work then.
Yeah, thanks very much. Yeah, yeah, cheers
I
for that.
I thought about myself earlier when we were chatting. Well, we've got six rods out there, mate. We're both happy with where they are. We've got a night and a morning.
And a morning and possibly a lunchtime and possibly an evening.
And maybe see you Saturday. see you Saturday, Mrs. Humble. Mrs. Herbal Burble.
Why are you going around to see her?
I don't even know where you live. Nor does John the cameraman. Absolutely. Seriously, we've got a night left, mate. Who knows? It feels good. We have seen a few. There are still a few up here. They've got no reason to move. The anglers that have moved in near us are opposite us, aren't they? So that might do us a favour and push.
Yeah, it could push them. And the breeze is swung round this way a little bit more. Well, it's not ideal, but it's could be worse.
We'll see, mate. So if we don't see you in the night, basically is what we're saying, exactly what we said last night, or I said, Spencer, we'll let you know what's going on in the morning, which will be absolutely zero, but hopefully...
Fingers crossed with a whacker.
We'll catch you in the dark hours. Night-night from me.
And me.
Oh, why can't every carp fishing morning be like this? Tench just before first light, redone the rod, middle rod, little pineapple and cream pop up, 12 miller, over my F1 corn. This is why we come to Sandhurst to do this, these commons. 3612 of beautiful Sandhurst common carp. I knew it would happen. Of course I knew it would happen. We were talking about this last night, weren't we, Spence? So, we were like, God, I hope it happens in the morning because we've got one more bite time to go through. And there you go. Not disappointed with that at all. You'd be mental if you were. Nice little tench. Oh, that was nice. Of course it was, yeah. And this one after, 40 art out. still might be another chance. We've got another 4 hours yet and we are effectively in what they call bite time. Avid Adventures 7. Well, I don't know if it could get any better than that, but for me, that is a rather special fish, a big chunk. On our adventures again, happy as a Larry.
Well, you've seen Ian just put that lovely comment back. We've got a few hours left to go. As you can see, the weather has changed dramatically from what we've had the last few days. Actually feels a bit more like winter now. But we've got fish showing. They're still showing out here. There's lots of weed coming up. As you can see, they're churning it up. Freshened spots up with just a little bit more bait this morning. Still same presentation, still got them out there where I'm just feeling for a drop. As long as I'm getting a drop, I'm comfortable that I'm fishing. That's the plan. I'm just hoping that really I can catch one more so that I've had more than chemo. That would be the icing on the cake for me coming along on an Avid adventure. Fingers crossed for some more. We have a fish in the weed. I can't feel a lot happening at the moment, to be honest. Just take it steady. And hopefully, we'll be able to do something with it. Basically just dragging in a massive ball of weed at the moment, I think. So hopefully there is a fish somewhere in amongst it. I'm gonna get Ian to come and drop my lines for me in a second. I have absolutely no idea. Could be a tench.
Yes!
Come on!
Is it that 10 pounds? We weigh him with all the weed, he's 73 pounds. Can we weigh the weed as well?
Well, told you it looked good for another one. 5 minutes later, the rod ripped off and this absolute scaly cracker was on the end. Wasn't a massive tussle because it was basically weeded all the way in. But I think we can agree it was worthwhile. Absolutely stunning fish. And whilst it might not be as big as Ian's, it's definitely better looking. Well pleased with this one. Fingers crossed, we've got time for some more.
And that, my friends, is the end of our adventure number 7. Great trip.
Fantastic trip.
Mate, really, you really were worried, weren't you, to be fair?
I was worried, yeah. February, it's been cold up until last week.
I'm not on about your acting. You have been, Brad Pitt will probably, very likely, be in touch with your agent today because you're quite posh.
I was worried about being with you, to be honest.
I'm not surprised.
And the cameraman, of course. And the cameraman.
Great lake, though, all joking aside. It's been a mega trip. When we got here, I did get here early, as we know, but I managed to get us at this end of the lake because we were totally on our own.
Correct.
I've been on my own with Spencer. And the fish weren't here, were they? But they've gradually shown up. We've had a good trip, mate.
Fantastic. Really good. Really enjoyed it. Nice place to be. Yeah, great company, although of course.
Although the big fish angler of the two of us has had a couple of low scraper, almost not 20s. He's had two, but four bites between us.
It's not all about size.
Yeah. One of mine come adrift. I had a tench.
Oh, you did have a tench?
Count the tench?
No.
Because you unhooked it. I didn't even touch it.
Yeah, no.
You touched my tench?
It doesn't count.
You rubbed my tench?
It got me up in the early hours for
you
that.
You rubbed my tench, mate. With that, you know that, you know that when your mate says, oh, I'm in, but it feels a bit funny. I shouldn't say that, really, should I? But
I've you just might want it. To rework
anyway,
that.
That was a tench. And then an hour or two later, I had that lovely common. Spencer's had what I think is the fish of the trip, that low 20 mirror.
It was a lovely looking fish, yeah, stunner, absolutely stunner.
Fluke. But, you know, better to be lucky than good, really, I suppose, isn't it?
Of course, always.
Thank you, Sandhurst, all joking aside, mega lake, well known for big commons. Even though we didn't get one. That's about it, really, isn't it? We've had a good time. We've loved doing this, and we sincerely hope you enjoy watching it as much as we've enjoyed making it. And it's just as well, though, because we really thought, I'm going to end on this, we were going to do
a shed.
No!